Okay, hello class 12th. Today we are starting with a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Electric Potential and Potential Energy. So now let us start with the electric potential first. So what is electric potential? The electric potential is the work done in bringing the charge from infinity to a point inside the electric field. That means when we carry a charge, when we are bringing a charge from infinity, then in that case what we have to do, we are moving a charge, so for moving a charge we have to do the work, and that work is stored in the form of a electric potential. Now mathematically it can be expressed as V equals to W upon Q. So this is the potential, V equals to W upon Q. So when we want to find out the dimension of this, so simply we have to break this W into F into D. So we have broken this into F into D, putting the dimension of force. The dimension of force is ML2 minus 2. So we have put the dimension of force, the D is measured in, the dimension of D is L and dimension of IT is AT. So solving it, we are getting ML2 T minus 3 A minus 1. So this is the dimension. For the SI unit of potential is volt. So electric potential is measured in volt. And now let us define this volt. Now we know that V equals to W upon Q. So V is written as W upon Q. That means the work done in moving a charge. So let us define the voltage from, let us define the volt from there. So for this, the unit of electric potential is volt. Work is measured in joule and this is measured in coulomb. So there, from here, from this definition, if we know the mathematical expression, then we can define this volt. So thus 1 volt is the electric potential when 1 joule work is done in bringing the charge of 1 coulomb from infinity to a point inside the electric field. That means 1 volt is the electric potential in moving a charge of 1 coulomb inside the electric field. Now after this let us discuss about the electric potential difference. So electric potential we have already discussed. So electric potential is the work done when the charge is placed at infinity, we are bringing that charge inside the electric field. Now the potential difference, now the charge is already in the electric field, so now we are moving this charge in the electric field itself. So to define it, potential work done in moving the charge inside the electric field from one point to another. That means we are moving a charge inside the electric field from one point to another. Suppose we are having two point A and B. So the difference calculated, the potential difference calculated, of point A and B is called the potential difference. Now after this, let us move further. For this, we are having the small derivation now. Electric potential due to the point charge. Now what we have to do? We have to calculate the electric potential due to the point charge. For this, what we have done? We are having this plus charge. It is kept at point O. So we have kept it at point O, and we are having a point P which is at a distance of R from the O, at where we have to calculate, where we want to calculate the potential. Now suppose the plus Q charge is situated at infinity and we are bringing this charge inside the electric field. So again, that means that we have to do work. Now it is plus charge and this is also plus charge, so the force exists between them, and that force can be given by the Coulomb's law, that is F equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q0 upon x square, where K is the dielectric constant of the medium. Now suppose we have moved this Q0 by the small distance dx, so the small work is done. So let us calculate this dw. So dw equals to F into dx, that is force into displacement. The displacement is dx, minus dx, we have taken minus dx because we are moving against the force, that's why we have taken this minus dx. Now integrate this. On integrating this, we get the value of the W. W equals to, we have put it the value of this force, force already calculated by the Coulomb's law, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon this much we have put it, and the charge is kept at infinity and we are bringing inside the electric field. So this will be the value. X square is the distance of this charge Q from point O. So now on integrating this, we are getting Q0 4 pi epsilon 0 K 1 upon x. We have put the limit infinity to R. So now further solving it, we are getting W equals to Q0 4 pi epsilon 0 1 upon R. Now V equals to W upon Q. So V equals W upon Q. We have put it the value of this W, which we have calculated. We have put it the value of W and Q0 get cancelled. Q0 get cancelled with Q0. And we are left with V equals to Q 4 pi epsilon 0 K 1 upon R. Where K is, if that value of K is equals to 1, then we get V equals to Q 4 pi epsilon 0 1 upon R. So this is the final answer. This much volt is the potential difference. Now this V is inversely proportional, because this is constant, so V is inversely proportional to R square, and we know that intensity of electric field is inversely proportional to R square. So it means that electric potential and the electric field varies with the value of R. So that means when we are changing the value of R, the electric potential and electric field both changes. Now one thing more, this electric potential is the scalar quantity, but its potential gradient is the vector quantity. So remember this point, that electric potential is the scalar quantity, but electric potential gradient is the vector quantity. Now moving further, now let us calculate the potential due to the group of point charge. Now suppose the different charge are situated at a distance of R1, R2 and R3. We have situated the different charges on these points. So and at R1 we are having a charge Q1, at R2 Q2 and R3 Q3. So different charge, so we are calculating the potential difference. So V equals to, this will be common, so Q1, Q2 and this much is the answer. Okay, now potential due to an electric dipole. So we know, we have calculated the intensity due to the electric dipole. So now we have to calculate the potential due to the electric dipole also, but this we will discuss in the next video. Okay, we will discuss this in the next video. So please start making the notes. Okay, start making the notes, and I will send these pictures to you on the WhatsApp into your group. Thank you very much.